Oh, this is the
Once upon a time, two men decided if they were making the cut. Then they made the cut. And now JT and Aaron are talking everything from wrestling to pop culture and beyond, because it's no holds barred.
Will you back down, turn and run, or stand up with the best?
It's no holds barred.
Is okay. So, does John Cena count as a celebrity or not?
Depends on what year it is.
How about Nikki Bella?
About The Rock.
Nikki Bella, guys, is that a celebrity?
Are you guys impressed that Jenny and I called each other and wore purple?
Mm. You didn't have to tell everybody.
Steve really? Being under me looks like I'm that shirt is like an extension of my shirt. Like,
but your head is a giant head.
Yeah, we always forget this is also audio. So, hey, everyone, this is No Holds Barred. If you're hearing us talk about clothing, it's because we're also on video on our YouTube channel, North South Connection. Draft day. It's like your worst time of the month, but it happens twice. Here we are going through another draft exercise. Me and Aaron, producer Tim, running the show. Also with us tonight are Miss Jennifer Smith and Mr. Steve Bennett in the draft war rooms. Guys, how are you?
I'm scared. Hello. I don't know.
You know.
After that Hi, last Paul. Draft, I don't know. I don't trust you guys. I don't trust any of this anymore.
That's right. The shadiest little guy from Boston is not here. So outside Boston.
I do have a question though. Has it ever been explained why these aren't snake drafts?
They are snake. They're a snake.
Okay. I was looking at something and there's a complaint it wasn't a snake draft.
Oh, well, that person doesn't understand what a snake draft is. If
someone... Yeah, I'm not sure.
It is a snake
Absolutely
draft.
Absolutely a snake Fair draft.
Enough, sometimes the complaints snake will draft. Be false.
Yes, that's all of them usually.
Well, yeah, anybody complaining is full of shit.
Who knows?
Well, I watched the first one where Jenny didn't know any of the competitors, the draft.
Mm-hmm. Hold on. Mm-hmm. Well, hold on. And he said snake draft.
So I don't know.
Oh God! Yeah,
you gotta do the snake draft. All right,
hiss, I'm a snake.
It's a whole thing.
All right, so for tonight's snake draft,
Why
we're doing
with snakes on TV.
Can we just do this? We're doing WrestleMania celebrities.
I want a
celebrity
know.
To have appeared at WrestleMania. Producer Tim, are there any instructions that we need to hear for our listeners and for us on this draft?
So, for the instructions on this serpentine draft,
snake-like.
Thank you.
Attributes.
You are drafting not a entire celebrity's body of work at WrestleMania, but you're drafting a celebrity's.
Are we drafting a celebrity's body
involved?
So you can draft based on a celebrity's body. Yes,
that's my
yes.
Joan Rivers.
You absolutely can. You can be as vain as you want to be, but you are ticking a specific place and time in which the celebrity did something at WrestleMania. So if a celebrity were to show up at multiple WrestleManias, you pick one. You make it good.
Got it. All right. Mm-hmm. As we usually do here, Tim is going to play lead us in a little game. The winner of that game will get to determine the draft order of the snake draft.
We're busting out.
Oh boy.
The wheel.
Okay.
And you'll see I'm on this list too. If my name comes up, I'm setting the order.
Oh God. Shit. Let me guess. Ryan, Marcus.
Here we go, baby. Roll that beautiful
fucking
footage.
Seizure.
Oh, great.
No, it wasn't rigged at all. Jesus Christ.
I already said I don't trust
Good old Tim Riggins. Yes. Good old Tim Riggins rigging another draft in front of our eyes.
I've trusted Tim the whole time. I trust
old
him with the rules.
Tim Riggins.
I trust him to be fair.
My hand This is great stuff. I love
bring
it.
In another one. Yeah,
I've been good with Tim the whole time.
So,
for the voice messages say otherwise.
Tim, you're looking really handsome.
Thank you. I try.
Did I ever tell you how strong your judgment was about The Rock being a C? You did not buckle. A lesser man would have buckled on that.
I'm going to show love.
Chris Golo would have flip-flopped 35 times on that.
I'm showing love to the guests. So, Steve, you're up first. Jenny, all right. You're going second.
All right.
Now, let me guess.
Aaron,
yeah.
You'll go third.
What a shock.
And JT gets the back-to-backs.
I've never done the back-to-back. Well, I guess it
it's
is.
It's a high corner. No.
Collusion. Collusion again.
I'm all good. Maybe if you said some nice things to him instead of just attacking him for two straight episodes. Perhaps then.
So I have 7 minutes, right? I'm on the clock.
Yeah. First round is
seven whole minutes.
You will lose your pick.
First round is 7 minutes, and then by the time we're done, it's like 30 seconds.
Yeah. All right. Well, I will select the most important celebrity appearance ever at a WrestleMania by one of the biggest stars to ever appear in WrestleMania. And certainly one of the strongest from one of the greatest television shows. I will select from A-Team University, Mr. T, WrestleMania 1, main event wrestler, Mr. T.
Very good first pick. That would have been mine if I was not colluded. Good choice.
You have to think like the actual WrestleMania kind of hinged on Mr. T. Like it was a very, very big deal that T is involved and as
Vince
involved
was all in.
As
Vince
he is.
Had all his money on that. Vince had all his
yeah,
money
for
on
sure.
That.
Like he maybe mortgaged his house one time, two times, possibly three times, but he got the number right. He got Mr. T in and 38 manias later, working on 39 and 40. Still going, baby.
It's right after Colin Jost at WrestleMania 35. Like it's on that level.
It is. It's right up there.
But not Michael Che.
Just Colin Jost.
Well, one of them like is married to Scarlett Johansson.
So. I'm sorry, I felt like Mario Lemieux turning into Sidney Crosby card. It was a no doubter. It's picking Andrew Luck first overall or Sidney Crosby or well, Michael Jordan didn't go first overall, so I have to say LeBron James, right? But it was a no-brainer. So,
right. No doubter. No doubting that Jenny, you're on the clock.
All right. Well, I decided to do something a little bit more contemporary, so I went Johnny Knoxville from 38.
Good choice.
Not even on my list.
I had a feeling that might be the case. What was the last WrestleMania you watched, Steve?
30.
Okay.
Too long for the days of that Madison Square Garden.
Daniel Bryan won the main event. That was 30, right?
Yep.
And I watched Stone Cold last year. Like I watched him for 10 minutes or whatever.
Yeah.
So I could say last year's.
Okay.
5 minutes of last year's.
That was Johnny Knoxville. So there you go.
Knoxville and Knoxville, honestly, a very integral part to 38. Mm-hmm. He really kind of like with Mr. T really embraced being in the WWE universe at the time and
he killed it. Like it was awesome.
The match was way too good for its own good. Like,
hell yeah.
It was spectacle beyond spectacle. The one man spectacle himself, Aaron, you're up.
WrestleMania 28. John Cena. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to rehash that. So my fear with doing celebrities as well as the one we did 2 weeks ago, which was the draft list, when you made the Ultimate WrestleMania card, is that there would be overlap. And already there is because I'm taking Floyd Money Mayweather against the Big Show.
Oh, greatest celebrity match. Very excited right now. Did you see that match, Steve? Mayweather?
No, also not on my list.
Ooh, right. Strong.
My very list strong. Ends at WrestleMania 5, so I mean.
All right. God, Claire Peller may make it. Well, I wasn't sure. Spoilers. I wasn't sure if she was going to get in. But she may make it.
See how going forth can be a benefit?
Yeah.
Because it sounds like you have a master plan.
I got two right now that I can't believe I'm about to get both of them.
It's fallen to you. So what do you got, JT? One and two.
I was like prepared to have to find a backup, thinking no way I'm going to get both these celebrities. My first one did what Mr. T did at WrestleMania 1 at WrestleMania 14, and that is Mike Tyson, special guest enforcer referee for WrestleMania 14, Austin versus Michaels. Aaron and I talked all about it in this very here podcast when we broke down that match, how integral he was to the rebirth of the Attitude Era megastar, one of the greatest WrestleMania celebrity appearances of all time, Cold Stone. And my second round pick was also a big time star, also helped bring in a very casual audience at a very important time. Again, it is girls just want to have fun, and that is Cyndi Lauper. Massive celebrity get for them and for everything she did. She wasn't just she didn't just come out and do like one show.
She was amazing. She was
awesome that whole run.
She took a bump.
Yeah, the whole thing with the record and all that, the garden, and then just get it like the crossover with MTV was so big for them going to WrestleMania 1, as big as Huge. T was. Lauper, like my goal coming in was to hopefully get one of T, Tyson, and Lauper. So to get two of them, tickle
Lauper number two on my list.
I figured. I knew I was taking her off there for you. That's why I knew I had to take her there too, because I'm like, there's no way she was getting past you.
Monumental guest appearance by Cyndi Lauper.
For sure.
And do you get David Schultz as well? You get her boyfriend?
David Wolf. David Schultz might have choked her out.
David Schultz. David Wolf. My apologies. Yeah. Yes, you get David Wolf as well.
I'm all right. I'll turn down the 2-for-1 on that one if I can.
You know what, Wolf?
I'm good now.
Hey, Ron. Hey, Ron, you are up.
Wolf was better in the Christmas play three years ago than he was on it.
So this is probably early for him, but I want him. I've got a weird strategy for this one that's probably different than everything.
On our TikTok. I want him. Yeah.
I want Tim. I'm going to WrestleMania 14. Give me Pete Rose.
Yeah.
I want him harassing the crowd. I want him attacking Kane and getting the life beaten out of him.
God, all three How Roses. About it? All four Roses, right? Doesn't he do when he gets inducted to the Hall of Fame? He shows up again, right? Like later? Yeah. So there's four of them. But that's the best. That's the iconic one because
he was always good.
City of Losers.
Boston,
I left my friend Bill Buckner tickets, but he couldn't bend over to pick them up.
I don't know, man. The San Diego Chicken is a rather good.
I thought of that one too.
The last one's great too. And that with Kane and Rikishi gives him the stink face.
Right. I just want that promo where he's just the promo is awesome. Boston. Yeah.
Well, because no one anticipated him. The other ones, once he came out, you knew what was happening. That one, when Kane tombstones him, you just never think this is going to happen. It's like insane that it even happened.
Right.
So you get that plus the promo.
For sure. Jenny, you're up again.
All right. Well, I think I'm going to do Bob Uecker.
There it is.
Which one? Baseball. WrestleMania 3 or WrestleMania 4?
That's the one I was debating. Let's go 4.
Yeah, good choice.
Yeah, good choice. You get the strangulation by Andre the Giant.
Well, that.
And he's great calling the Battle Royal, too.
Yep.
And he finds Vanna at the end of the tournament.
And he finally got renewed. His contract was finally renewed.
Yeah, it was picked up. He's also the first person to like acknowledge Vince as like the owner. He's like, I want to thank Vince McMahon for picking up my option. The girl's like, oh, right, yeah, let's move along.
I wanted to pick Vanna there, but
pick her next round.
Hey, Jesse Ventura, big time movie star.
Big time celebrity.
Mm-hmm.
Some would say. Steve, you are up with your second and third pick in the draft.
Well, you could definitely wouldn't have lasted any longer than that. So it's a good pick by Jenny. I'm surprised she knew they've been at WrestleMania. But I'm going to pick the Prince of Darkness, one of the greatest rock and roll superstars of all time. Another guy who's super into it, probably because of cocaine, but man, he really was really into it. And he said he would be back. and has never been seen again. So I was like, Ozzy Osbourne.
Finish belongs forever.
Forever. I'll pick Ozzy with my first pick. And with my second pick, I will stay
Herb
in Chicago Herb at WrestleMania 2
Herb
and pick William the Refrigerator.
Oh,
Perry,
that's a good one. That was on my
such,
list.
Such yeah. a big deal in 1986. Yeah. You have to have context. The Chicago Bears just finished one of the greatest NFL seasons in the history of the sport. The 85 Bears still talked about. You know, they win the Super Bowl that January in New Orleans. And then he is in the ring competing in the Battle Royal in Chicago. Does a great spot with John Studd. And like, I think part of the criteria for me is, are they just showing up to take the check? Or are they right. showing up to really be a part of the event? And you couldn't ask more from the fridge here on this day. So I'll take the fridge and take Ozzy. Two celebrities from one city in a WrestleMania with three of them.
Yeah, that's pretty solid.
The fridge wasn't making it back, so you were good to take him there because he was my next tier down.
For sure. Fridge, a WWE Hall of Famer. Mm-hmm. And Ozzy. He does kind of come back to the WWE a little bit later during the Raw guest host era, but that is a definitely unremembered time in WWE history. So,
and the Bulldogs were still looking for him when they left. You know, he never.
Dynamite was looking to break his leg.
Dynamite and Dave, yeah, they were, yeah. Okay, he came back then, but not quite forever.
Not quite. Forever's just a day. Jenny, you are back up with your third pick.
Well, I think I need a little sex appeal. So I'm trying to choose between these two ladies.
Reba McEntire.
Reba.
Gary Hart.
When I think sex appeal. When I think sex appeal.
I got to go Elvira from WrestleMania 2. My love of horror, and she's fantastic. She has a bunch of good assets.
And it's memorable too. Like I feel like when you think of, like everyone remembers that
she's
shot
into
of her
it
and with Jesse and everything.
Yeah, she likes it. Yeah.
She was into it. She was great on color too. She was one of the very few people ever who's called a match at WrestleMania, right? Like she was in the booth.
It's her and Matt Stryker.
and still respectfully, Elvira.
Right, yeah.
Still,
like
still
legit.
Top shelf.
Great to pick. This day. Yeah. Yeah.
To the day.
Great.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Great pick.
She's known now as a wrestler, which is weird. Back then, she was a celebrity, but now everyone knows her as a wrestler now.
Yep.
It's weird.
Aaron, you are back up.
Well, lots of places to go.
Tons.
I got scared for a minute.
Tons of value.
Yeah, tons of value. So my whole thing was not to take too many matches, I think. But I feel like I got to take a match here because I want, if I'm going to take a celebrity match, I want the match to be good, right? I've got the best one with Mayweather show in-ring quality wise. So I think for my second one, I'll go with one that was kind of a big deal at the time. I'm going to take LT.
Yeah, that's a good one. I had it queued up too ready because I was going to take it next.
Yeah, yeah.
What a man.
That was coming next, so good choice.
Sending it. JT, your third pick, and then we'll do our mid-draft recap before you come back with pick four.
All right. Okay, for this next one, I'm going to pick another one. I have a feeling maybe on Steve's board, so I'm going to take it now. It's one of the most iconic America the Beautifuls ever for multiple reasons, both the performance and the introduction of Aretha Franklin.
Yep.
Very good. Very good.
That was my number one in the singing department.
I had to do it just so I could do the voice, but
now you're taking three and not 23, right?
Yeah, three. The iconic three. Her on the
piano. When he's doing this.
Yeah. Aretha Franklin. But I think, I don't know if she gave the best America the Beautiful, but I think it's like the most remembered. There's another one that I think is the best. I'm not going to say it in case it goes, but I think it's like the most, when you kind of think of WrestleMania, America the Beautiful, it's like she's at the top of the list.
Amazingly.
Without question. In a recap, we have, let me get Let me get this image out of the way so we can see everybody's beautiful faces. But Steve in the first takes Mr. T, follows it up with Ozzy and Refrigerator Perry back to back. Jenny goes Johnny Knoxville, Bob Uecker, and Elvira. Aaron goes Floyd Money Mayweather, Charlie Hustle, Pete Rose, and LT. Very sport-centric for Aaron.
And all and assholes. Then,
yes.
Right on brand.
And JT has got Iron Mike felons. Tyson, Iron Mike Tyson, Cyndi Lauper, and Aretha Franklin. And we get to roll on to pick number four.
Look, I didn't plan on going like all musically based, but I guess Lauper is like kind of was more of a performer than
and Mike Tyson doesn't sing very often.
And when he does,
except
it's great.
For in the
he broke do, like, his
sometimes
back.
When we no that's a. That's Pacquiao.
Okay. His back is anyway, broken. So my fourth pick is going to be...
It's final.
All About the Game.
And now you play it.
Because I don't know the words, but the performance is iconic. Motorhead, WrestleMania 17, playing out Triple H.
Not 21?
Not 21. They even know less words by 21, but 17, them playing out Triple H is an awesome live performance. One of the best that they've had for like playing out a wrestler. And that was like the end of like that was like Triple H was like still really liked and it was like exciting and everyone was into the song and Motorhead. Like it was just a cool get to have them actually there singing the song.
Smoking gun.
It's so great though.
Let me get like 9 words right in that song in that performance, but
that's
awesome.
High. That's too high.
It's like the it's like the Eddie Izzard sketch of like singing the national anthem. It's all about presentation and less about the words. So as long as you're like really impassioned about it, everybody gets it. Aaron,
God bless Lemmy.
That's right.
Well, I mean, look, I've got Floyd, I've got LT, and I've got Pete Rose. Okay.
Anyone else go to jail?
Hold on. These men got needs. They have some needs. I'm going to give them someone to help with those needs. WrestleMania 11, Pamela Anderson.
There you go.
Good one. Yeah.
When you said beautiful woman, I was like, uh-oh, there goes Pam Anderson.
I thought you were going to go somewhere else. With needs, I hope I'm curious if he'll go off the board or she, he or she will go off the board here later. But okay. That's a solid pick. Height of Power is Pam Anderson, WrestleMania 11.
Yeah,
that's
and
up
I was
there.
I was debating between her and Jenny McCarthy, but Jenny was just so into it, like she was so into being there that night. But Pam Anderson, so much at the time, was such a bigger star. So
right,
iconic, yeah,
for sure. Jenny, you are up.
I am. I feel like I need a musical act as well. I have a modern pick and a throwback pick.
Pick one.
Herb.
Fuck it. I'm gonna do Ray Charles.
There it is. That's the other America Beautiful I was talking about. I think that's actually the best. Job. I think it's the best performance.
It's really
of
good.
America Beautiful. Yeah.
Little long though. Little wordy.
It is. But I think it's the best performed.
Okay.
To my reflection.
It's got to be up
well
there.
Done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right.
All right. I will pick one of the people on the list that has a claim to true GOAT status, like undeniably the GOAT of boxing.
Yeah.
And that's Muhammad Ali, WrestleMania 1. I know they wanted the role to be more than it was, but unfortunately his illness was a little bit too much for him to overcome. And this is at the beginning stages of kind of the public finding out how, I guess, injured or sick he was, but he's still, man, when he jumps in that ring at the end in the scrum, he's ready to rock. And I mean, he's a GOAT. He's an American icon beyond WrestleMania or sports or anything else. He transcends just about everything in our culture. So I'm very honored to have Muhammad Ali on the squad.
Very solid.
With my first pick. Yeah. With my second pick, I have to have someone from the greatest WrestleMania of all time. And I feel like maybe in the locker room, Ozzy could feel a little bit left out with the group that's there so far. So I'm going to give him another rocker to sort of maybe relate to. And I hope that as a 1-2 punch, they can provide the team what we need. So I'm going to select from Detroit, Michigan, one of the great rock and roll showmen of all time from WrestleMania 3, Alice Cooper.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. You get the full Nelson on Jimmy. With the snake.
Right in the ring. Into it.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. Definitely solid. I'm not sure that's where I thought you were going to go, but a very solid pick nonetheless. Jenny, you are up with your fifth pick.
I am. All right. We need
tons
something.
Of value.
Yeah, yeah. I'm trying to think of what I need.
You need Jenny McCarthy.
No.
I do.
Herb, still there.
Clara, where's the beef woman?
Is she on this list?
Claire Peller, yeah, yeah. Claire you Peller. Can have her yeah. if you want.
She does a great job, too.
Yeah.
Rings that bell.
She really kills it. She kills it. I mean, you can almost hear her.
You know who I like? I like Joan Rivers from WrestleMania 2.
That's what very good.
Yeah, we need somebody funny. We need a funny lady in there.
Jenny, so. The WrestleMania 2 mark.
Apparently.
A true celebrity. You know?
Three straight from WrestleMania 2 right there.
Three straight. Yes.
I mean, 2 does have a lot of celebrities. So
it's yeah, I mean, it's celebrity. The fifth.
And ones I like. So, yeah.
11 and 2, I think, have the most.
Yeah. Between the two of them.
Yeah, that's the fifth Joan selection Rivers. From WrestleMania 2. So,
Jesus
yeah, RIP.
They had goat. Like 50 people on it.
That's very true. On. Very true.
I still have three on my list from that Mania.
Yeah. Those early Manias were definitely like flooded with stars because, again, like WrestleMania is a brand that needs some staying power. So as much rocket fuel as it can be fed to get it to stick, that's exactly where it goes. Aaron, you are up.
All right. Well, I clearly have a brand going.
Yes.
Right. And this next pick. Boy, does this person fit right into this brand.
Assholes?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. And, you know, it probably doesn't affect me as much, seeing as where I'm
I was
from.
About to take this. So it's okay.
I've got yeah. it right here.
Go so, ahead. I was about to take
no,
it.
Anyway. Undoubtedly, the highest status person to ever be a celebrity in a WrestleMania.
Oh, fuck.
Undoubtedly drove the biggest buy rate in history to that point.
It's
Give
huge.
Me a... Give me 45.
Oh, God.
Give me Donald J. Trump.
What appearance? He was in many.
I'm going to take 23, WrestleMania 23.
Oh, I would have picked 4 or 5, but.
No, he doesn't do anything there.
Horrible stunner.
He punches Vince.
He just stands there. He watches.
He's calls him Bobby Lindsay. No, no, he's more active.
The great Bobby Lindsay. We love you, Bobby. No, 23, I mean, he is great at that show. Like,
he's the draw. Yeah, he's the draw of the show, right?
Yeah.
It was.
He should have just stayed in wrestling instead of politics.
No, he made like, politics wrestling. That's what
would
you're
have been a lot more like yes. revered if he just stuck around in wrestling. He was good at it. Anyway,
where did it all go wrong, Donald?
Here, there.
In some timeline, JT. He's you know, he owns all this shit.
That's right, JT. 5 right. and close it out.
Oh, my last two. Shit.
Last two
is already
compared to the last draft we did. This is right. a speed run.
It's been very peaceful. Nobody's been angry.
Because it's
really.
A lot. This is definitely like a palate cleanser draft compared to the last one. You can go back and watch it on YouTube at NorthSouthConnection.com. Right. That was a lot of mental gymnastics, a lot of moving
I don't recall
pieces
that.
You had to count. No?
You don't recall
did
that?
Did you blank? Did you Men in Black flashy thing yourself and get it out of your system that quick?
Yeah, I don't know. I
Rage
thought it was,
forgot.
I thought it was okay.
Yeah, it's good.
I don't remember any issue. All right, my fifth pick. I'm gonna go modern, and I'm gonna take a worker because I haven't really taken one yet. That actually was in a match, and that is Bad Bunny, who I think is one of the best WrestleMania in-ring performances in a match.
Don't even know who that is.
I know.
There's another modern one that I think you were, I was expecting you to
say
there, that I think is a bit better, but.
Yeah, you think so? All right. Yeah. I like Bad Bunny. I think he's great in that match.
That the from the Warner Brothers cartoons?
Yeah. Yeah, that's the one. Yeah. That's the one.
Yeah. Yeah.
He fought Elmer Fudd. No holds barred.
The old rotten rabbit.
All right. My final pick, if anyone's been listening to any of my podcasts for a long time, would know
where I'm going
with this. Knows where I'm going with this.
Yeah.
Oh, hi, folks. I'm here in this appropriate acoustic.
Are you playing music?
To rehearse the Russian national anthem with my
Steve Allen, WrestleMania 6, in the shower, playing the piano with the Bolsheviks. One of my all-time favorite WrestleMania moments. He's fantastic. Just everything is so good. But even the timing, I don't know if Nikolai and Boris even knew what the fuck was going on, but their timing is like perfect in the whole thing. And it's the last one that gets me because they're already so mad. And he's like, no, we're really going to do it this time. He's like, I get no kick from Ukraine. And now they're like really mad. And then there's like, all right, now we're really going to do it. And then the toilet flushes. Which is...
I was at that WrestleMania and they didn't play that in the arena.
Disturbing.
So I didn't actually see that until Coliseum Home Video or whatever came out. So months good. Later, so yeah, very he's good stuff.
Probably wasn't even filmed that night.
Well, he does announce the match. It might have been because he's probably. I doubt he was there another night. He does do the Jimmy Sicka. Do I get that? I guess I get that too, right? I get all his WrestleMania 6 or no? Just the one skit.
Yeah, you get the whole 6. I
his appearance of 6, right?
Oh, so yeah.
Yeah,
I get him talking about
6.
Yeah, him getting Jimmy Sicka wearing his mother-in-law's underwear. I get that. I get that in there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, very good. That's a double bonus. Aaron, I wasn't even thinking of.
Close
Aaron,
it out.
You got a motley crew.
Time for Rhonda Barrett.
You got a lot of bad dudes.
Yeah.
Going on here.
Yeah. So I got to go with a music pick because I don't have any so far. And I'll be honest, it's slim pickings when it comes to assholes, right?
Please take.
I could think of one.
I got one. I don't know if it's. I don't know if it's what you're thinking. It might not be. Because at first, I was like, you know, I'm Canadian. I got to pick Robert Goulet. But I'm not picking him. I don't know if he's an asshole. And then I was looking at the rest. And, like, there's only one singer that, like, kind of desecrated America the Beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
And then later on, played the main eventer to the ring.
It's not the one at WrestleMania 11. Oh.
I'm going to take.
Timestamp that, please.
No, do not. I'm not proud of that joke.
Yeah,
get it out.
I'm going to pick the DX band.
Yeah,
as my last pick because they fuck up that anthem. Everybody hates like
it's great. The playing Sean out though is fantastic.
Oh, it's so good.
Play Triple H out too or just Sean? I think they play Triple H out too.
I think you're right.
Mm-hmm. I think they play them both out. That great. I mean, that live. I had that clip. I downloaded like on my computer at that point where you just download random songs or whatever. And I used to listen to it all the time. It was such a great performance.
So
Chris Warren and the DX band. So good. That's not who I thought you were going to go.
I can't. As I was looking at my list, I think you're thinking of someone not on my list because like,
probably.
I was like,
probably
who else is an asshole? Like
Nicole Scherzer.
We'll talk about it.
There's nothing wrong with Willie Nelson. He's a nice man.
I don't want to give away any more picks. There's two more left to go.
Oh, sorry, I think
they might be safe. But Jenny, you are up.
All right.
Snooki's still there.
The buffet is
she
full.
She is. Yeah. Uh-huh. I need...
The Rock is still there.
Hard pass.
Hard pass on The Rock.
Could you know me?
Franchise Viagra? You're just gonna leave Franchise Viagra on the shelf?
Man, just playing by the rules because he's not a celebrity.
The Black Adam? You're not gonna take The Black Adam?
No, thank you. I'm gonna take Snoop Dogg from WrestleMania 32.
Snoop from 32.
Yep.
That's a good one where he plays out Sasha.
I need more weed smokers in my list. I was going to do Willie Nelson, but I feel like Snoop Dogg's a little bit cooler for me. So,
yeah.
All due respect to Mr. Nelson.
100% respect.
He still tours. I just looked up his tour date like recently. Like,
is he going to be anywhere good?
He's actually like near me like last weekend.
Got to go.
That's got to be a bucket list concert, right?
For sure. The bucket list tour bus too.
Yeah.
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 And for sure. Steve, you started it off fantastically with Mr. T. You get to bring it on home.
Snake draft style.
Last pick. Your last pick of the WrestleMania Celebrities draft. Who do you got?
Well, this is what they would call a deep draft, right? There's
very deep.
There's more super deep. More players that could play in the league than we have spots for. And I want it to be known I'm gonna be very active in the non-drafted free agent market as soon as this draft ends. There's gonna be some people I'm gonna want to bring into camp. And I have a lot of people left on my list. Mary Hart. I would love to pick her. Billy Martin, former Yankees manager. I'd love to pick him. Hello, Snake. But
he's got a cobra.
I can't turn up the opportunity to literally have Frazier and Ali 4 in the locker rooms on the playing field. I have Ali from 1. I will pick Joe Frazier from 2, and I have the greatest boxing rivalry of all time on my team. So
will they be fighting?
Joe Frazier.
They might
fight.
Why not? No, they have to make out.
And they did not like each other. Joe Frazier was very, very bitter about the way Ali talked about him leading up to their fights, especially the third one. It's going to be a lot on the coach to manage their personalities, and I appreciate that challenge. But too much respect for Ali Frazier to leave him on the board, especially for Mary Hart.
Fair enough. Let's go. Let's run down the draft board and talk about some honorable mentions that we've got. Steve got Mr. T, Ozzy Osbourne, William Refrigerator Perry, Muhammad Ali, Alice Cooper, and Joe Frazier.
Steve's list finishes nobody in 1987.
Right on brand. I wish you would have just taken one, like just shocked the world and taken one person from like 2020.
Kim Kardashian.
Gronk.
Jenny goes Jenny Knoxville, Bob Uecker, Elvira, Ray Charles, Joan Rivers, and Snoop Dogg. Aaron's got Floyd Money Mayweather, Pete Rose. I need to change that spacing. Lawrence Taylor, LT. Lawrence Taylor. Pamela Anderson, Donald Trump, and Chris Warren in the DX band. And for JT closing it out, winning 3 back-to-backs, Mike Tyson and Cyndi Lauper, Aretha Franklin, and Motorhead, and Bad Bunny and Steve Allen. A ton of picks still left on the board.
Another win for me, by the way. Another great job. Undefeated still.
I thought when Aaron was going with a musical pick, I thought that the best pick possible in a draft with Pete Rose and Money Mayweather and Donald Trump, Kid Rock.
Yeah, yes. Right there. Surely it's Kid Rock.
Yeah.
Why is Kid Rock an asshole?
How much time do you have?
He has a great bar in Nashville.
Just because you don't like his politics, right?
No, not just his politics.
You'd be an asshole and agree with like someone's politics. Felon, right?
Correct.
Well, he could have fit, but he was already taken. Well, he wasn't taken at that point.
Oh, okay.
He did go, though.
Correct.
Right. Who?
But Snoop. I think the Kid Rock would have fit in that line. Also, for me, off not taken, but I'm very, very... sad that Ice-T from WrestleMania 2000 didn't go
on my list.
Literally saying one of the best lines in WrestleMania history, Godfather's in the house, bitch, is so great. I'm trying to think. My son, Jonathan Taylor Thomas,
on
the board.
Yeah. I was gonna grab him last, but I was like, I don't know.
One I was gonna take, when I thought we had one, I had 3 more picks instead of 2, was Morton Downey Jr. from WrestleMania 5. I think that's a pretty memorable one. Yeah, like that's
love to have him. Yeah,
that's a memorable one with him and Piper. I mean,
it hurt me to leave Living Color on the board because I think that's such a good play out for Punk at
29.
And a personal favorite. I mean, I don't know if he's an asshole. I mean, he certainly hurt his family, and that's Ray Combs.
Yeah,
I love Ray Combs at 8.
Yeah. Yeah.
Rest in peace.
Ray Combs from that was 8.
If Allen went Combs, is going to be my last pick. But
and like a sneaky one that like It's just because he's so disinterested as Burt Reynolds at 10.
Yeah, like, I had him.
He could just want to be anywhere else other than that.
For sure.
Regis was a good one. That could have went too.
And
Regis
Trebek.
Is seven.
Oh, Regis, yeah.
Regis, Trebek.
Regis, you're beautiful.
Robin Leach.
I had Robin Leach and Liberace.
Yeah, Liberace is famous for being a mania.
Jennifer Flowers gets you that Rock interview.
Mm-hmm. Right?
Yes.
That's great. That's great.
Is it 14?
Yeah.
14, yeah.
I wish that Mania Rap at 5 was better. Yeah, Little Richard was one I considered. Run DMC. You just can't hear
Little
the rap.
Richard, one of the worst renditions.
It was bad.
Of, lip sync the whole way.
Johnny B. Bad could have done better.
Right.
Get him out there.
Boyz II Men, though.
Boyz II Men, I had on my list.
Boyz II Men were really good.
Joan Jett
is awesome. At
yeah,
35.
Playing out Ronda. Yeah.
Right, yes. Playing out Ronda.
No love for Joan Jett, Jenny?
I like her, just not Rhonda. So
what about the who's the band that is Wyatt's song at 30? Is it 30 that they play them out? That was
yeah,
great.
There's that one, and Rev Theory does Orton's at 30.
Yeah, that's a good one.
What about
Rick Schroeder is a great Rick Schroeder.
You kind of get Salt and Pepper with LT.
Yeah, with LT. Yeah,
right.
I'm surprised nobody took from WrestleMania 2 Tommy Lasorda, like since we're so heavy on.
WrestleMania 2. Chad says Mary Tyler Moore, which actually is a pretty good one. She's like,
yeah,
kind of a mess out there.
A lot of good athletes from WrestleMania 2 didn't go. Like Daryl Dawkins is a big star, you know.
Bill Frelick.
Bill Frelick. Yeah, and Francis.
I almost
like.
Good.
I was just gonna say, looking at our teams, like I think the most likely player to not make it out of training camp and get cut is probably the DX band. Like, I know it's a fun pick. I don't see that making the team, though. You know, I think you just slot someone else in there. But
I almost went hometown with Vinny Paz as well. If we had a couple more picks, he probably would have.
I think the DX band just adds so much to that show. Like,
right.
And it fits within the theme of, like, of assholes that I was going for. But, like, they play the anthem, they play out two guys, and, like, that Michaels entrance is like great, one of the greatest to me, one of the greatest of all time. Like it's so legit.
I consider them like early. Like if the first round went against how I was picking, like if Tyson went, Lauper went, and well, I guess I would have gotten T or Knoxville probably, but like I consider them high DX band because of that.
Yeah, like I really wanted to pick people that were involved in the shows, right? Yeah. Like not just like
same. Valet. For sure.
There's also Mongo at 11 was great.
Yeah, thought of Mongo.
Yeah. Fred Durst.
I would argue that Pamela Anderson is not an asshole, but that's me. She's the only one that.
No, but she's like a bad girl, quote unquote.
Okay.
So she fits. She dates the assholes. So she fits into my scheme.
All right.
Asshole by osmosis.
Yeah.
Mm. I think you work.
If you rub up against them enough, you just...
Yeah.
I'm looking at the list. I think most of the big ones are gone.
I'm trying to think if there's any big, like, I think big ones.
You know me, I'm like a Maria Menounos mark. Like, I think she was great.
I had her.
Because she was really into it, too. Like, I mean, she's like a big fan. But
very pretty, too. Very
Liberace.
Pretty.
Liberace. Nobody picked Liberace and the Rockettes.
Liberace.
The Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders.
Shaq. What about Shaq?
Shaq. Yeah.
Or, you know, I'm actually surprised nobody, at least I'm not surprised Steve didn't take it, but like I think Logan Paul probably has it.
I almost did do Logan Paul.
Mind you, I guess he's become a wrestler now, but at the time he was
McAfee too. I don't know if he counts, but I mean he was
he was an active McAfee announcer. Counts. Like
Vanna White is another one.
Yeah.
Yep.
Vanna White was on my list.
Very I wanted to take Marla Maples, but I figured that would just be too much tension in my team.
Yeah. That would be cool. You think Frazier and Ali is bad, man.
All right, let's wrap it up.
In my locker room.
Another draft of the book. Share with us what if, I mean, I think we named almost everyone, but if there's any celebrities you would have taken in a different spot, let us know on social media. We're on Twitter, Facebook, Ronda Rousey, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, NorthSouthConnection.com. Check out Steve
on
Sportscasters podcast as well. You can follow him on Twitter to check that out. And everything we got, NorthSouthConnection.com. Subscribe on YouTube. Smash that subscribe button right now if you like this nonsense. Even if you don't like it, just subscribe and just ignore them when they come up. Who cares? Help us out. We'll be back next week with another No Holds Barred Greatest Duty Title Change Ever. In 2 weeks, we'll be back on the draft. Until then, the Dookie's dropped. Later.
Jockass, how about it?
Aretha.